eventually created some problems. They did it in the movie, and Vet said, yeah, that was pretty
cool. Cricket for sale in all the museums and all.
It's more for Hollywood.
Yeah, it's for, you know, souvenirs for tourists, because the troops didn't use them.
Yeah, that's for a damn.
Say in the tent.
So here will be the new here will be a brand new
bathroom. New bathroom. Okay. Yeah, but that's good.
So we will see.
A producer from Paris. It sounds very nice.
Yes. So you know this new generation.
Were invited to sit at the table with Winters and his people. In the course of the dinner, he invited General Vines and I to go with them on a private walkthrough of Breckert Manor, the first time they had been back since World War II. And of course, we immediately raised our hands and thought that was a good idea. So what I'm going to relate to you is pretty much is that the time is compressed. So instead of 17 minutes is what the sequence is. Now, let's talk about the troops, the 101st and Winters precisely. This is E Company, the normal strength of E Company. This is dropped, not where he is supposed to be. This whole high ground area was a drop zone for the 101st. It went from St. Comte-Dumont to the south, Dead Man's Corner, all the way up to actually Pander, and Winters was left commanding the company, but it wasn't really a company. It was basically a heavy squad. St. Mary-Glise, because you saw a road sign that said St. Mary-Glise. And he knew that was not where he was supposed to be. Guys over at the farmhouse area where he meets the battalion commander. Malarkey said that they were tired, they wanted to sit down. What happened to Winters with the advantage that he got to see a road sign that said St. Mary-Glise, so he didn't have to worry too much about where he was. He had that fit. But remember now, the combat unit had was pretty much broken up. Winters low crawled essentially the last 50 gun number four. The hedge rodeo, and he was going to do the best he could with the 12. There was no doubt in his mind he was going to any of these artillery pieces. The plan rested on taking the machine gun and then sorting it out. So it actually stuck his head out initially, would wait for Compton on signal, and so Winters gives a thumbs up to Compton. Compton gives the thumbs up back. Fire starts. The two machine guns on our side comes in. Winters comes assaulting in, and overhead is lifting. Wham! In less than about two, probably less than 30 seconds after the firing started over there. So immediately Winters has the machine gun position, and he's got gun number one. He's also got a couple of dead Germans and a prisoner. He's also got one guy starting to get a couple of people. He could tell by the gunfire that Winters was engaged and would need all the help that he could get. So he sent down his S3 along with two other troops and a bag of thermite grenades and some ammunition. The grenades go into gun number three. Gun number three is assaulted then from down the trench line. However, you still got the problem of gun position to take. So what do the troops do? They stop, they smoke, they have some chow, they kind of get the rack together.
Me too. I think it's because I just really struggle with seeing things that are like letters and numbers and I just I get it wrong all the time. So
struggle.
Yeah.
So because this is like a very intricate piece. There's a lot of going
what's
on.
What's gonna happen is you'll go to edit and you'll be like, oh my god, I wish I got more B-roll.
Yeah.
And you'll find out you don't have enough to like cover and now you have to go look for